Welcome, welcome, welcome. It is time for the Legal Lounge here on CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com, streaming live coast to coast and around the world on CRNTalk.com, also available on our Roku channel, CRN Digital Talk on the Roku, also available on Tiki Live, directly in video on our website, as well as on Facebook, facebook.com/CRN Talk, streaming live as well on Periscope, CRN Digital Talk, Twitch, Mike, GCRN. And of course, like I said, on Facebook, I'm joined by the one, the only, Mr. Richard Nixon Esquire. He's a practicing attorney, noted author, America, Illusion of Freedom, and all-around great guy. Richard, how was your week?
My week was great. In fact, it was bolstered by the fact, you remember last week, we talked about those protesters in Hong Kong and the fact that they were waving the American flag. Well, now I see this week, they're singing America's national anthem.
The footage was absolutely striking, yes. Richard. Over 1.2 million people from Hong Kong in the streets fighting for their rights. Now, we've talked about this briefly before, about protesting a recent proposal by the Chinese government allowing extradition of citizens of Hong Kong to mainland China.
Yes.
We all know China has a very harsh criminal justice system.
Yes.
Very, very harsh indeed. And it was amazing. And this has ramifications geopolitically as well as economically. We see these Hong Kong citizens, these young people marching, yearning to be free. But also, I mean, we should know that we're involved in what might be somewhat consider a trade war with China, and the President Trump is trying to walk a fine line on supporting these protesters but also having free and open negotiations with the Chinese. Your thoughts on the President, how he's handling this?
Well, he's doing the best he can. He's telling China in a nice way, you should sit down and talk to these protesters. We don't want any violence. And I think implied in that is that if China does act in a negative way against these people, he's just going to use his increased tariff power against them. So they kind of have to behave.
Well, also, I think that the president needs to be careful as well, because if he does condemn the Chinese government, you know, if there's a crackdown, China can once again float their currency, devalue their currency. And we saw what happened to the bond market when they did that last week.
Again, but again, he can retaliate again by simply increasing the tariffs again. So I think we're in a good position, but as we said before we went on the air, Mike, I'd like to see the president do some of these, make some of these threats just between him and the Chinese instead of to the public.
Yeah, I mean, I think before the show you said maybe, one of his great qualities, some people say one of the reasons he got elected was his direct relationship with voters via Twitter, but you think he might need to slow down a little bit on Twitter, huh?
I think so.
Yeah, exactly. You guys, we got a big show today. We got a lot to talk about. We're two bills in California, state of California, where we're broadcasting from. Senate Bill 826, which mandates by the end of the year that female members of corporate boards based in California, you have to have a quota system of female members on corporate boards. Very interesting. Also, recent developments with felony murder. We're going to talk about that. Richard's going to give us a great explainer on that and maybe some changes to the felony murder rules. Maybe briefly touch upon the Commerce Clause. And then an interesting article in the Daily Journal about an ERPO, which is colloquially known now as the Red Flag Law, an extreme risk protection order. We're going to talk about that and maybe segue a little bit to the Second Amendment. So stick around, you guys. We're in the Legal Lounge, CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com, Facebook.com/CRNTalk.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
Thank you.
back in the Legal Lounge, CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com. Thank you so much for joining us, all of our listeners around the world, coast to coast, our listeners on Facebook, facebook.com/CRNTalk. Everybody watching on the Roku channel as well. So, Richard, this is an interesting case right now. This is comes from the Jerry Brown administration. This is one of the last things that he signed before leaving office.
Yes.
This is a California law requiring female directors for public company boards. This becomes effective 12/31/19 at the end of the year. This is Senate Bill 826. It adds sections to the California Corporations Code and requires each publicly held domestic or foreign corporation with its principal executive office located within the state of California to have a minimum number of female directors serving on its board of directors. With this new law taking effect, the California becomes the first U.S. state to require public companies to have female directors on their boards. Richard, your thoughts?
Well, we've got a lawsuit going regarding that. The Los Angeles County Superior Court lawsuit seeks to halt SB 826. That's the 2018 law signed by, as you said, Governor Brown, that requires all publicly traded companies headquartered in California to have one female board director by year's end. And the people that are suing claim that this law violates the state constitution. It was mentioned in a case called Crest versus Padilla, and that it's a California law that constitutes a quota law. And under California's constitution, they claim, the constitution prohibits sexual discrimination in any way. So they seem to have a good argument that you can't favor women over men, according to the U.S. and state constitution.
Yeah, that's one of the principal legal challenges to the Section 301, that it violates the Equal Protection Clause.
Yes. And this has been before different cases. Padilla was a good case that we just mentioned, where the justices decided that they would not change it. It was up to the legislature to make such a change, and I think they're right.
And also another possible legal challenge to this is possible that Section 21 15.5, which states that the requirements of Section 3.013 apply to foreign corporations, not only California-based corporations, but let's say you're a foreign corporation where your executive offices are based here in California, that would violate the Internal Affairs Doctrine and is unconstitutional under the Commerce Clause. Does that make sense?
Well, it does and it doesn't. But what I'm more concerned with is the fact that we've had a war on men since about the 60s, 1960s. And this is just one more facet of that mindset, that for some reason men must be disadvantaged to the advantage of women. I am not sure that women appreciate this either. Women take the position that they don't need help anymore. They're just as tough and strong and able and capable as men. Yet every time we have a situation, I should say we have many situations where the women are running into court to solve their problems. And I think it's clearly a violation of the Constitution. If we're going to pretend to believe in equality between the sexes, we cannot favor the women over the men in this particular case.
Well, what about the 14th Amendment implications here, Richard, as well? Because women, I believe, are not a protected class.
Well, that's right. And if you're a strict constructionist, as I am, the Equal Protection Clause of the 14th Amendment was never intended to talk about equality between sexes. Its equality was concerned with the people who had been slaves versus the people who were never slaves. Mm-hmm. That's the equality that the 14th Amendment in 1868 was directed toward.
And I mean, this could have implications on California being able to bring businesses from out of state. I mean, these are corporations, but there's still family-held corporations out there. Like, think about the Waltons,
yes,
for example. I mean, do they have to change their board of directors? Oftentimes you see these companies that are family-run where they have, the dad, the mom, the son, the daughter, all on the board. We're going to have to kick off Junior because he's not...
Well, that's right. And I think it's be impossible to implement. And I think the sooner it goes before the court, the better, to find that you cannot do what they propose to do. Although you might argue that they're well-intentioned, that is to say, they want to make sure that women are accepted as equals in our society. But I think in most cases, in fact, in law school now, there are more women in law school as men. And so that bodes well for their future in terms of future lawyers.
Also, I mean, how is this enforceable as well? I mean, are they going to sanction these companies that don't have parity of gender on their corporate boards? This would be a civil matter, right? They'd have to pay fines?
Exactly. And again, like you said, we're going to create maybe more work for the lawyers is what it's going to do, because, again, we go back to the simple words of the U.S., the California Constitution, which basically prohibits discrimination regarding sex.
And this is exactly pretty much what that is. This
Absolutely.
Is discriminating against male board members.
Right.
And this should be left up to the shareholders. I mean, I don't think that, you know, we talk about community standards. Shareholders are our community, and if they want to enforce these kind of rules, they can do so via shareholder vote. But to have this being enforced by statute, by law, just reeks of authoritarianism to me.
Yes, and, you know, the U.S. Supreme Court has held in several different instances where quotas are constitutionally suspect. Now, they haven't said that they were unconstitutional, but they would be given strict scrutiny if the case comes before the U.S. Supreme Court.
It's very similar to affirmative action. We've seen cases out of Michigan and cases out of Texas where the affirmative action issue based on college admissions has been debated, and looks like the tide is turning on that
Yes.
as well. And this is sounds like the same thing.
Well, Justice O'Connor said years ago that she thought that some of these protections for minorities and women were appropriate for the time, but the time had come when we should actually recognize these minority groups, including women, as now equal and capable of fighting for themselves. And they don't need these courts intervening in their lives to correct it.
Well, like you said, Richard, the majority of college graduates in this country now are women. The majority
Yes.
of upper degree of graduate and doctorate
Yes.
are women now. And so I think this is actually does a disservice to women, making them, you know, it's almost like, we have to take care of little Jenny here because, you know, we have to. But no, they
Exactly.
can handle themselves quite well. I mean, based on all the girls that I know and all the women I know, especially working in the office, they're the ones that keep this place running, you guys. So stick around. We're going to talk about another interesting California state issue. This is concerning the felony murder rules, criminal law issue, you guys. So stick around. We'll be talking about that. See if any of the rules are going to be changing on that as well, you guys. So stick around. We're here in the Legal Lounge every Tuesday, 4 p.m. Pacific Time, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Replays throughout the week. Also available on podcast, crntalk.com/podcaster. Also, every session available on YouTube, on our YouTube playlist. Just go to YouTube for our CRN Digital Talk channel. Find Richard Nixon live. You guys, stick around. Be right back.
The widely popular book, Where'd You Go, Bernadette, is in theaters. What does actress Cate Blanchett say is one of her favorite relationships in the film?
There's a cataclysmic relationship that she has with her neighbor, from her perspective, a busybody parent at the school. And often the person that you have the most antagonistic relationship, you have a lot in common with. And I think that's a bit of a revelation for both of them.
Where'd You Go, Bernadette, rated PG-13. Rated PG-13. For this entertainment answer, I'm Matt Mungle.
Welcome to your island home away from home at Ka'anapali Beach Hotel. Relax and unwind on 11 acres of tropical gardens by the whale-shaped pool or in a beachfront cabana. Enjoy your favorite ocean activities, culture activities, and free nightly entertainment. A perfect setting for weddings, honeymoons, family vacations, or just a weekend getaway. Experience Aloha at its best at Hawaii's Most Hawaiian Hotel. Call 661-0011 or visit kbhmaui.com and let us welcome you and your ohana to ours.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet, fresh asparagus, hollandaise on the side, a filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flare, close your eyes, and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Ruth's Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef, broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at RuthsChris.com or by calling 800-544-0808.
The smartest way for you to get the lowest prices on your plane tickets, domestic or international, is to call SmartFares, first or last, but you've got to call us before you book your plane tickets. Fly anywhere in the world, fly anywhere in the U.S., and SmartFares can save you up to 75% on your plane tickets. We have the lowest airline ticket prices on over 500 airlines, and you've got a great 12-hour free cancellation window. Plus, with our live agent help, you can always get fast help and fast answers. So on your next trip, maybe today, maybe tomorrow, how about right now? Pick up your phone and call SmartFares. Plus, save up to 75% on your plane reservation. So call right now. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644. 800-915-2644.
Back here in the Legal Lounge, CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com. A lot of good things coming up for the Richard Nixon Live program. We're going to be developing an app. We're going to also be developing two new websites for Richard. It's going to be really, really great. Looking forward to that. Make sure to check out his fantastic book, America, An Illusion of Freedom, available on his personal website. It's also available on Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com, as well as on iTunes. And any vets out there that knew Richard during his time of service, give us a call here at the office, 818-818-6400. We'd love to connect vets, and we'll also we'll also provide you with a free copy of Richard's fantastic book. These criminal cases, the criminal matters, you know, are right at my wheelhouse, Richard. I'm a big Law & Order fan, you know. I love reading crime books, Michael Connelly and whatnot. And this is a doctrine, this felony murder doctrine, which is embraced by many states in the union. This is pretty much, give us our audience kind of what is felony murder?
Felony murder is first-degree murder based upon the fact that the defendant is engaged in some kind of felonious conduct. For instance, robbing a bank, if you will. He's one of the people involved in the robbery. And it's, in a sense, it's kind of bizarre in the fact that even if there were an agreement between the parties that there would be no shooting, no lives would be taken, and the most innocent person in that concert, if someone is killed, all the people that were part of the concert or the conspiracy are automatically liable for first-degree murder. And that means if a policeman is killed, a bystander, or even one of the perpetrators themselves, no matter who's killed, all the members of the conspiracy are charged with first-degree felony murder.
Here's a case we can talk about that outlines what you just said, Richard, perfectly. Late in the evening of January 27, 2004, four teenagers broke into an elderly neighbor's house in the Southern California town of Paris looking for cash. One of them, Sean Khalifa, guarded the back door. Sean, who had just turned 15 years old, slipped into the kitchen and stole some chocolate candies. He briefly saw the homeowner was seriously hurt and ran back outside out of fear. No one accused Sean in the trial or the police of laying a hand on the victim, Mr. Hubert Love, but a jury convicted Sean at age 15. They tried him as an adult of first-degree murder, and he is currently serving a sentence of 25 years to life. He did not pull the trigger. He did not inflict violence on the victim, but yet he's held just as culpable as the ones that did. Is that fair?
Well, yeah, that's the question. Is it fair? Because now the point is this. I don't know that young boy stealing chocolate or something, whether he was necessary in any kind of conspiracy. But if you look at it in the context, let's say, of the lookout or the getaway driver in a bank robbery, that person is key. Even though that person was not in the bank, and even though that person may not have had a firearm. So it's the idea is that at any time that when you know that violence could be in the offing and someone might get killed, you have an obligation, if you don't want to be held liable for the crimes of the group, is to withdraw, to take overt action to withdraw from the conspiracy, and that way you can't be held liable.
And just to clarify something you said at the open, Richard, is it true? So let's say you and I go out and rob a bank.
Yes.
And unfortunately, during this robbery, I take a couple from the police, and I'm shot by the police and killed.
Yes.
You could be charged with murder.
Absolutely. As I said, since you were part of the conspiracy, you put this whole thing in motion by being part of this conspiracy, you are liable for all the negative ramifications, including murder, that ensue.
That's fascinating to me. We're going to talk about maybe how this felony murder rule is softening a little bit. We're going to talk about, ethically, is that if this is a good thing or a good thing or a bad thing, if this serves as a deterrent. Many argue that it does serve as a deterrent for especially young people and also for gang members. Prosecutors say if we do reduce some of these felony murders, I guess we'd say qualifications, this could really hamper prosecutions against gang members. We're going to talk about that right after the break, you guys. Any questions, comments, or concerns, drop us a note on Facebook, facebook.com/SierenTalk, in the comment section of the video, or shoot Richard an email, richardnixon@SierenTalk.com. Also, make sure to follow him on Twitter, @RichardANixon1. That's @RichardANixon1. And we'll be right back right after the break.
Experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain, pain from a sports injury? If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Hi, everybody. Michael Horn from CRNTalk.com. You know, we provide you with the best in talk radio. 8 channels of talk radio, from radio on the left, radio on the right, sports talk, business talk, religious talk, Spanish talk, you name it, we've got talk radio for you. All at CRNTalk.com. Well, now we'll bring you video as well as audio. That's right. Watch your favorite shows like The Robert Conrad Show, The Fred Dreyer Program, What's Cooking Today, What's Cooking on Wine, The Lounge, and so many other shows in video right at our website, crntalk.com. You can also watch us on Roku. Just search CRN Talk, and you can watch us on Roku on any TV anywhere in the world. Also on Facebook Live. Go to facebook.com/CRN Digital Talk. facebook.com/CRN Digital Talk. Roku, search CRN Talk. Check us out on Tiki Live and at crntalk.com. Video for you talk fans, all from CRN Talk.
Hello, I'm Fred Dreyer. I've had a MyPillow for 2 years. Before that, I had sleeping problems. Pillows would go flat, I would flip and flop all night, I would wake up with a sore neck and a sore back and maybe even a headache. Made right here in the United States with a 10-year warranty and a 60-day money-back guarantee, there's nothing to lose. For a limited time, go to MyPillow.com and get a 2-pack of MyPillow premiums for just $69.98. That's only $34.99 per pillow. And it's only available at MyPillow.com when you use the promo code WINNER. That's two premium pillows, just $69.98, with the promo code WINNER at MyPillow.com. Or call 800-513-3363. That's 800-513-3363 or MyPillow.com promo code WINNER for a fantastic offer.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit MyPillow.com.
Do you want to fly somewhere, anywhere in the world? Smart travelers call MyFlightSearch.com for the best deals on flight tickets. Going to Manila, Bangkok, London, how about Singapore? Call MyFlightSearch.com for the lowest flight tickets available. What about a local vacation? Let's say you want to fly to Vegas, Orlando, Miami, Los Angeles, or Denver. Pick up the phone and call MyFlightSearch.com right now. We have exclusive deals that you can't find anywhere else. The only way you can get these low airline prices is by calling us. We have so many low prices available, we can't possibly tell them to you right here and now. If you're flying somewhere anytime in the next 6 months and you want the lowest airline ticket prices anywhere, you owe it to yourself to save a ton of money. So pick up your cell phone and call MyFlightSearch.com right now.
Call 800-445-3166. 800-445-3166. That's 800-445-3166. Call now. 800-445-3166.
And we are back in the Legal Lounge. Richard Nixon live, CNN Digital Talk Radio, CNNTalk.com, Facebook.com/CNNTalk, talking about felony murder. And a measure is in front of the California Senate, California State Senate. Right now, the measure already approved by the California Senate, cleared another important hurdle Tuesday when it won the blessing of the Assembly's Public Safety Committee, despite strong opposition from law enforcement group. If this bill passes, California will join a growing number of states in abolishing or severely restricting felony murder, this doctrine where if you are part of the crime, even if you did not commit an act of violence, you're held just as culpable as those that did commit those acts of violence. And proponents of this measure, which would limits the application of felony murder, said it disproportionately affects women and young people. A survey of over 1,000 prisoners convicted of murder found that the felony murder rule of the women serving life sentences for murder, 72% of women who were serving life sentences for murder in California were not the actual killers, but involved in the felony murder itself, either as bystanders, as drivers, as whatnot. Richard, what are your thoughts on that?
Well, that's interesting because I think we've all seen movies where the husband or the boyfriend is the violent person and he's got a girlfriend with him and he's doing all these crazy things. She wants no part of it, but she's along there with him and she loves him. So she's faced with what? Do I leave this man or stick with him? And anyway, it's a difficult call to say that she's as liable for these things as he is. But so it seems to me that the standard should be, and I don't see anybody addressing this standard, is the extent to which the so-called innocent person was necessary in what was done. For instance, I think that a getaway driver waiting outside for the guys to come out after robbing the bank is an essential part of the success of the robbery. And therefore, that person, even though that person may not have committed any violence, should be held liable. But as you mentioned, another case where the young man went back into the house for some reason and stole some chocolate and saw the victim was in bad shape but didn't render any aid. I don't know that little boy or young man, if you will, was necessary in the success of the conspiracy.
Well, let me ask you this, Richard, just as a point of clarification.
Yes.
Let's say you and I were riding down the street, you know, had a nice meal or whatnot, and you say, "Hey, Mike, I got to make a stop real fast." And you pull up in front of the liquor store. You run into the liquor store and you run amok and you commit multiple murders. And you run back into the car. I had no knowledge you were commit that crime. Would I still be subject to the felony murder rule?
Well, again, yes and no. The argument is going to be: was there really a conspiracy or an agreement before you went into the liquor store? And of course, you're going to argue no. I had no idea that, or one of the, you know, the innocent party, so to speak, is going to claim he had no idea the other party was going to do that. And if that other party is legit, he's going to say the same thing. There was no agreement. And therefore, no, you would not be liable. But it's a good law school question, because that would be the issue. To what extent did the parties agree to something beforehand? If there was no agreement, no conspiracy, then there's no felony murder rule.
This proposed legislation would not undo felony murder entirely, but it would carve out the group of people who had very little involvement in underlying crime and no intent to kill anybody, like you just said, Richard.
Yes.
And that's going to be very hard to prove from both sides.
Well, that's right. But I think the criteria that they use are saying, number one, he did not kill anybody. He did not intend to kill anybody. But they don't say that whether or not he was necessary in the carrying out of the conspiracy in the first place. If he was a pivotal person, even though he didn't pull a trigger, I think the felony murder should apply to him.
Opponents of this bill argue that people will be less likely to commit crimes if they know that they would face maximum penalties if someone dies. Quote, the deterrence value in people are discouraged from participating in serious, dangerous felonies, said Sean Hoffman. He's legislative director of the California District Attorneys Association. And this was a scare tactic that I know a lot of children were given to about running with a rough crowd. And I'm
going
to speak about deterrence. I remember, you know, my parents told me, look, don't hang out with that rough crowd, because if you get in a car with that rough crowd and something happens, you can face the same kind of punishment that they did, even if, you know, you weren't involved in the crime. And I think that specifically applies to children in gang-infested areas and you know, very, very dangerous areas where, you know, they run with the rough crowd, they're going to get those consequences.
Yes, and I think those people, quite frankly, gang members, they learn young. They know full well if they get involved in some kind of altercation or felony, that they're all going to be dragged in and they're all going to be held responsible. So I think finding an innocent person among the gang members is remote.
And this isn't the first time that this has been talked about, felony murder, especially here in California. California courts have criticized felony murder, but leaving the rule intact. In 1983, the California Supreme Court called felony murder a, quote, barbaric, unquote, and rule of, quote, dubious origins, end quote, from a bygone era. But they concluded only the legislature could change it.
Yes. In fact, the article that I read talks about the case People versus Dillon, where 1983 Justice Stanley Moss stated the court was asked to somehow amend or overrule the felony murder rule, he said that the court could not sit as a super legislature and only the legislature could amend the statute. And of course, he was correct.
And also, I mean, this has other implications too, because California has kind of become a national laboratory for prison reform when the U.S. Supreme Court upheld a court-imposed cap on the state prison population. So it almost seems like California is trying to find a way to not send as many people to prison.
Exactly. And again, we're on this tear to somehow minimize criminal activity amongst those who have committed crimes, I think. And of course, we haven't mentioned the fact that Kamala Harris was part of enforcing the felony murder rule in her years as prosecutor and attorney general of the state of California.
Yeah, that's interesting that Kamala Harris, who's, you know, as she's been campaigning for president, has become kind of the social justice candidate, but
yes,
yet she hasn't addressed the fact that she has sent thousands, especially thousands of minorities, to
absolutely
state prison for a long time. So if any reporters out there want to ask Kamala Harris about that on the record, we would encourage that, you guys. So stick around. We'll be right back right after the break. Talk more about legal issues, constitutional issues here in the Legal Lounge. CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com. Make sure to check out Richard's book, America, An Illusion of Freedom, available on Amazon.com, available on iTunes, and as well as BarnesandNoble.com.
Thank you, Mike.
Stick around, you guys. We'll be right back right after the break. More in the Legal Lounge. CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com, Facebook.com/CRNTalk.
Do you owe back taxes to the IRS? Newsflash, the president has changed the tax laws, and now you may be able to pay the IRS less. If you owe $10,000 or more in back taxes, the tax doctor can help you pay the IRS as little as possible allowed by law. There are new tax laws for business owners, the self-employed, even W-2 workers. If you have a back tax problem or a few years of unfilled returns, new help to save you money is now here. Call right now to see how the new tax laws can help you. Plus, right now, we'll waive the consultation fee and give you a free tax savings report. Attention, business owners, the self-employed, and W-2 workers. Make this free call to the tax doctor now and learn how to take advantage of the new tax laws that may help you pay the IRS less.
800-985-1610. 800-985-1610. 800-985-1610. That's 800-985-1610.
If Ernest Hemingway was alive today, would he say this to you?
Shakespeare, Mark Twain, Edgar Allan Poe, all great writers. And after reading your book, I simply must add you to the list.
Wait, you don't have a book yet. So make a free call to Page Publishing. Their expert staff can help you turn your book idea into a real book, a masterpiece that could someday make the bestseller list in hard copy and digitally all across the world. Page Publishing can help you completely take your idea for a book, write it, and publish it. So if you want to join the ranks of some of the most famous authors in the world, call now for a free information kit. Turn your book idea into publishing gold. Make a free call right now to Page Publishing.
800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. 800-378-3212. That's 800-378-3212.
We are back in the Legal Lounge, CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com. Thank you so much for joining us. Moving on, we've talked about the issue, Second Amendment issue, here on the show before, and an interesting article popped up that Richard brought to my attention concerning the red flag laws. And red flag laws can also be known in, colloquially as the ERPOs, which are Extreme Risk Protection Acts, who are targeted towards people who exhibit warning signs, and if those people should be disarmed. All sorts of constitutional implications here, Richard. Give us a kind of a breakdown of what an ERPO is.
Well, a typical situation is where a spouse or a female usually goes into court saying that the husband or boyfriend has beaten her up and she has physical signs. And the judge will grant usually a temporary restraining order, restraining the husband or the perpetrator, if you will, and sets a date in the future, let's usually 21 days, when the husband is permitted to come in and address the issue. And the issue then in 21 days will be whether or not the court will make us a permanent as opposed to a temporary restraining order. So this is the due process that's afforded the husband, if you will. He comes in 3 weeks and he can say to the judge, Your Honor, I didn't do it, or she beat me up first, or whatever. But the point is, he will have his day in court, and the court can then order. Usually what happens is the court issues a stay away order that you can't get within 100 yards of each other to that effect. And they do at times extend that to if there was any threat of the use of a firearm, the court can obviously include that in the court's order. However, I don't know that the courts yet literally confiscate the gun or order the perp, if you will, to bring the gun in and turn it into the court. And I think that's what they're looking for.
Yeah, I think I have heard, just anecdotally, that firearms have been confiscated from people who have had these ERPOs taken out against them. And this article written by Kelly Sampson She makes, some might say, some spurious arguments on whether or not these ERPOs are actually can curtail gun violence, gun deaths. She quotes a statistic that I absolutely just was, I didn't believe it when I first heard it.
Yes.
But she actually said that, hey, these are great. In a study out of Connecticut, when Connecticut enacted some ERPO laws, for instance, they found that we reduced suicides over a span of 17 years. And you know how many suicides were reduced by this ERPO? 76.
Yes.
As we've talked about before, nearly 60% of all gun deaths in this country are suicides. So that's got to be, you know, in the 30,000-40,000 range. 76?
Yes, and again, she uses the word may. We're not even sure that these laws, if you will, caused the decrease or lack of suicides in any event. But she starts her article off by talking about the mass suicides or mass murders in Texas and Ohio, and then proceeds to talk about the ERPOs as though they're going to solve some type of, or shows that they've solved some type of suicide situation. The point is the article, I'm sorry to be so critical, but it's full of non sequiturs in the sense that she at least proposes to solve something and then discusses another.
Mm-hmm.
Suicide is not part of the situation that we're involved in when it comes to things like mass murders. We're not concerned with whether or not the perpetrator kills himself as well. That's the last thing we're worried about.
And part of her argument, too, is the legality of these ERPOs. She relies on the 5th and 14th Amendment, saying that about concerning due process, that these EPROs generally require the individual who's subject to these ERPOs receive notice and the opportunity to be heard. But she also says, and this is another instance of some spurious logic, that existing public safety laws regarding firearms are permitted, and she cites a D.C. versus Heller to back up that. But I'm concerned here, Richard. We've talked about the Bill of Rights. Second Amendment is pretty sacrosanct, and the language is pretty clear.
Yes, and of course, the interesting part about this is it's easy to say that you're being given due process, but when due process amounts to withholding a constitutional right from this person who up till now has not used a gun, and to say that that person cannot use a gun and must forfeit his right at least temporarily, what does that guy do in terms of his constitutional right according to Antonin Scalia and the Supreme Court, that a person has a right to protect themselves in their own home with a firearm?
Mm-hmm.
Is this person now automatically disarmed?
And here's an interesting one right about for the break. And so one of the fundamental things that are outlined in the Constitution are the right to bear arms, Second Amendment, and also voting rights. And to disenfranchise a voter, you have to be convicted of a felony.
Yes.
Now we're disarming people that haven't been convicted of anything.
That's exactly right. Well, he might eventually be convicted of battery, but again, as you said, he hasn't been convicted of anything yet. The most he stands to be punished for is a battery, which the court will then determine. But again, I think it's premature. On the other hand, I find in my experience that these temporary restraining orders, as we said before, the law only works for reasonable people. And if you're restrained, if you're ordered by the court to not do X, if you're a reasonable person, you'll refrain from doing X. If you're not a reasonable person, you'll tell the courts to go to hell, basically.
All right, you guys, very well said. We'll be right back. You guys stick around, wrap things up here in the Legal Lounge. CRN Digital Talk Radio, CRNTalk.com.
For the getaway of your dreams, come to Hawaii's Playground, Ka'anapali Beach Resort, on the fun side of Maui, where the world comes to play. Find your spot on Ka'anapali Beach with 3 miles of white sand, 12 resort properties, 2 golf courses, and 2 shopping centers. Enjoy the playground of Hawaii's ancient royalty. Ka'anapali Beach Resort is Hawaii's original master planned destination resort and home of the Hawaii Food and Wine Festival. With views of 2 neighboring islands, you can breathe in the land's natural beauty from your favorite resort or golf fairway. Come experience Kaanapali's own special brand of Hawaiian hospitality with world-class dining, relaxing resorts, water sports, and activities of every kind. For romantic, family, and great friend getaways, discover the options of Kaanapali Beach Resort, where the world comes to play. Plan your getaway today. Visit KaanapaliResort.com. That's K-A-A-N-A-P-A-L-I Resort.com.
We are the Debt Destroyer. Any debt you have, credit card, tax, student loan debt. Call now to get our free report that tells you how to destroy your debt. It's a great resource. Plus, when you make this free call right now, we'll have a Debt Destroyer expert ready to help you. They can show you how they can help you destroy your debt and get your life back on track. Debt problems don't have to be overwhelming. You can live stress-free and debt-free. Credit cards, medical bills, IRS tax problems, even student loan debt. Learn about free programs offered by the credit card companies, hospitals, and even the government that can help you slash your debt. Call right now for free information, including our Debt Destroyer Guide, a $300 value, yours free. Call right now.
800-515-6348. 800-515-6348. That's 800-515-6348.
The following ad contains shocking material. Listener discretion is advised. Is someone in your family playing a dangerous game of Russian roulette? Over 43,000 people die a year from drug overdose. 120 people a day. 5 people every hour. 1 person every 12 minutes. 88,000 people die every year from alcohol abuse. Over 240 people a day, 10 an hour, 1 person every 6 minutes. Somebody you know may be next. Learn how to help someone you love get away from the drugs, alcohol, and bad influences. With the FMLA, people can take a leave of absence from their job and still keep it.
Call Quit Drugs 321 now at 800-378-3315, 800-378-3315, 800-378-3315. That's 800-378-3315.
We are back, wrapping things up here in the Legal Lounge. Like I said, available on demand as well on YouTube. YouTube.com/CRN Talk. Find Richard Nixon's channel. All of our sessions are available on there as well. And like I said, make sure to check out his fantastic book, America, An Illusion of Freedom, available wherever fine books are sold. And Richard, you said something very prescient before the break, that the law really only works when reasonable people are involved.
Yeah, it seems to me that a law is passed, and who's going to obey the law? Reasonable people will, and unreasonable people won't. A good example, of course, is murder. Murder's been on the books in other countries before ours for thousands of years, but murder is still effected.
And that's, I think that's really the stumbling block that we're having. Of course, we want to see, everybody wants to see a cessation of these tragic gun events. You know, from going back this year, it seems like there's one every week. But like you said, if there is some sort of sweeping national gun reform, banning assault rifles, you know, high-capacity magazines, whatnot, unreasonable people will still seek out those weapons and still go out and commit unreasonable acts.
Absolutely. And as we said earlier, that if the federal government or even the states banished all firearms and ordered them returned within X number of days, the only people that would obey them would be the reasonable people who believe in following the law. And we would be left with the bad guys, the police, the army, and so on. And again, we must remember, now this might sound far-fetched, but one of the reasons for the Second Amendment was not to simply protect ourselves from our neighbors, it was to protect the people from our own government. That was the whole point. If you look at the Second Amendment, it says the federal government will not abridge the freedom of the people to arm themselves and arm themselves against whom in general? That didn't mean necessarily a foreign invader. It meant the government itself.
And similar to what the Bill of Rights, which we talk about extensively on this
yes.
show, was meant to limit the power of the federal government,
yes.
imposing those powers on, of the federal government on the states.
Yes.
Second Amendment as well, because if you look at the language, the establishment of state militias are included in there. So the founders wanted to make sure that the states had a way to protect themselves, even when it comes to arms, against a tyrannical federal government.
Yes. And it's become common knowledge, of course, that in the Second World War, when Hitler was on his rampage and before he became totally crazy, he confiscated the guns from particular groups, specifically the Jews. And so when it came time to, if you will, round up the Jews and arrest them for having done nothing wrong, they couldn't defend themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where we would find ourselves today, I think, if we simply just said, okay, everybody turn in all your guns, it'll reduce, and it might reduce some domestic squabbles and murders, but it would put the people at risk for losing their own country.
Very well said. Great way to wrap up. Thank you so much, you guys. We've been in the Legal Lounge with Richard Nixon. Richard Nixon Live here every Tuesday, 4 p.m. Pacific Time, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, replays throughout the weekend as well for you late night guys, people out there as well, available on CRN 4, CRN 5, CRN 6 at night as well, you guys. So we are here every Tuesday, like I said. Make sure to join us. Drop Richard a note.
Thank you.
Richard Nixon at CRNTalk.com. And join us on Facebook, you guys, Facebook.com/CRNTalk. Richard, until next week.
And Hong Kong, keep going.
Very well said indeed, you guys. Blessings to all of our freedom-loving people around the world. Take care.
In the CRN studios, we pride ourselves on being the station of every situation. You can always listen live through your local cable TV provider, as well as on our website at crntalk.com. But with TuneIn Radio, iTunes, iHeartRadio, and Stitcher, you can listen to the latest editions of our programs, like The PM Show, anywhere, anytime you want. Let Fred Dreyer give you his ace in the hole opinion on politics. Bring Hollywood legends and their stories with you to your next party, thanks to Robert Conrad. And of course, tell those Hawaiians the real meaning of aloha with Larry Minetti. For more information on how to listen to these great shows or many others, log on to crntalk.com and create your own listening experience today.
The Radio Channel.